Good morning and welcome again. I feel like Cookie Monster in the old Masterpiece Theater spoofs years ago. So welcome again to John. Thank you again for your participation these 6 weeks. Whether you have been kind of lurking around the sidelines and just doing the work, doing the reading, or if you've been engaged in one of those lively conversations that I have so enjoyed, thanks for taking part. And thanks to Martin, our faithful videographer, who shows up in my office and makes me look smart. I share your frustration if you are frustrated trying to get 21 weeks of really, 21 chapters, sorry, 21 chapters of really, really rich biblical narrative into 6 weeks was challenging at the beginning, and it's still challenging. So if you've been frustrated trying to hang on and keep up, I share your frustration. Please do the very best you can. My point was always to go for depth and not breadth, so that we would read enough of John's gospel, so that we would get the major themes of John, which is, of course, talks about lightness and dark and seeing and believing, things about who Jesus is, the identity of the Christ, themes about Jesus coming to his hour, and these long dialogues. And then a reminder that, of course, in John, Jesus is strong and powerful and always in charge. So that was my point, was that you would get those themes. And I think they've come out in our readings. Now we've got a lot of reading left to do. If you finished it, yay you. But John 10 is the preaching text for Ash Wednesday. And John 11, the raising of Lazarus, comes shortly after that on a Sunday. So those two will be covered on Sunday mornings or Wednesday nights. And then please stick with it as long as you can and as much as you can. And there's no, drop dead point. If you're not done by this point, it's too late. I'd be glad to continue to have conversations with you online for as long as you want to. Week after next, when I come back from vacation, I am going to do a survey, an evaluation survey that you'll get. It'll be really important that you fill this out, because this is the first of our online Bible studies, and I really want to know what worked for you and what didn't, and how we can do it better next time. So I'm giving you a heads up that that's coming, and then please do it and let me know how we can do this better next time. So I just want to close with a story, a little encouragement story that is one that comes to mind often when I think about biblical literacy and helping people of Emmanuel know the Bible. Dr. Harry Wendt, who is the executive director and the a deep, faithful man of God and a biblical scholar, he is the one who created and runs Crossways International. He told the story about what happened when the Iron Curtain came down, and Western churches were able to get into and talk with their Christian brothers and sisters in the Eastern Bloc nations. They were surprised to hear that during the Soviet occupation, they were allowed to have churches, they were allowed to gather for worship, they were allowed to have Sunday school, they were allowed to sing songs and hymns, they were allowed to have youth groups. The one thing that they were not allowed to do was to have Bible study for adults. I just think that's so fascinating, that even those sort of totalitarian rulers knew that the Bible is life-giving and transformative. And then once you enter into the Word of God, God enters into you and changes you, and makes you new and transforms you into a free and forgiven person. And that apparently was just too dangerous for people who were trying to keep Christians under control. So let that be a word of encouragement for you, and maybe even a word of caution for all of us who think we are too busy to read the Bible, that in that life-giving word of God, there is power, transformative power. So keep reading, keep at it, spread the word, and a reminder that God meets you when you meet him in the Bible. So thanks. God bless.